السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. On behalf of CII Radio, we present to you lesson number 579 of our daily Nasiha. Our topic today is those things that destroy a person and the public as well. An Anas bin radiyallahu ta'ala an, this is Anas bin Malik radiyallahu an, who was the khadim-e khas, the special attendant and the one who is to make khidmah and serve Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Look at how intelligent the mother was. Her name Umme Sulaim, and she came and brought him, Anas bin Malik radiyallahu an, when he was 10 years old. Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wasallam arrived in Medina Munawwara. He said, this young boy will make your khidmat and run your errands. And for 10 years he made the khidmah and served the master sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Qal, he states, qal al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the master alayhi salam said, wa amma al-muhlikat, those things that destroy an individual, those things that destroy an entire community and society, for shuhun muta', that people are very, very stingy and the people are still being obeyed. Meaning they are not prepared to spend their zakat and give zakat. They are not prepared to give their sadaqat, sadaqatul fitr and others. They are not prepared to spend on their wives and children or parents and siblings. So they are stingy, but yet people obey them because maybe of their wealth or maybe of their position or maybe the harm and destruction they can cause. So this is detrimental to the entire community, society. Wahawan muttaba. Today let us look at ourselves. We want to follow our desires. Everywhere we look for loopholes. So wahawan, and when people and communities start following their own base desires, their own base desires, worms, fancies, then remember, people are now going to divert away from revelation to reason. This is the logical, this is logical. Islam is supra-logical, above the logic, and we have to suppress our desires to come nearer and closer to Almighty Allah Jalla Wala, to enhance the love for Almighty Allah, to enhance the love for Mustafa Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and to practice on Deenul Islam. So once people suppress desires, that is the path of success. وَأَمَّا مَنَ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَا النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى. When a person fears standing in the court of all Almighty Allah, and they restrain themselves from their own base desires. فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ يَلْمَعْوَى. That place with people, Jannat is their resting place. And the third one, وَإِجَابُ الْمَرْءِ بِنَفْسِهِ. And people are self-conceited. People are impressed with themselves. My house, my car, my wife, my children, my business. So everything, my. So people are now with their degrees, with their knowledge, whatever it is. So this self-conceit, remember, can be the downfall of many, many people and many scholars and many presidents, prime ministers, whoever. So we should be looking at this hadith seriously and see, are we not of those people who are causing self-destruction? We cause destruction to ourselves, to our families, to the communities. So yeah, for shuhun muta', people who are stingy, but people are still following them, obeying them. Wahawan muttaba, people who follow their own desires and they don't try and suppress it. And people wa ijabul mar'i bi nafsihi, people are impressed with themselves and self-conceited. The hadith rawahu al-bazzar wal-bayhaqi. So each one of us, everything Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wasallam said is for our own betterment and uplift. And remember, we become a human being in the true sense of the word. Otherwise, we will then debase and relegate ourselves to the level of animals. Allah forbid. Quran Kareem states, Ulaika kal an'am, they are like animals, balhum adal, even sometimes worse than animals. So may Almighty Allah Jalla Wala give us the tawfiq, the ability to practice on Quran Kareem, the Sunnah of Nabi alayhi salatu salam, and follow the Ahlu Sunnah Jamaa. Assalamu alaikum.